What's going on, guys? It's Elias. Welcome back to another video. So as I sometimes say, another day, another problem. As you can see, my Kubota SVL75 is kind of stuck, but it got stuck in a place that I really wasn't used to seeing it stuck. You know, I went in and out of that hole a few times. Wasn't really a big deal, but something happened that is requiring me basically half a day worth of work to get it back out. Let's go take a look and let me show you what's going on. So whenever you're starting your day and your Kubota, your skid steer, your tractor looks like this, you know it's gonna be an interesting day. So I put it up in the air because I don't know what the heck was going on. I felt like my right track was not moving for some reason. So let's get a little closer there and I'll show you. Try not to fall here. Here it is. In case you guys don't notice, this is not supposed to be sitting up next to each other like that. And basically, the track came off the idler. Now, as you can see, I put a rope on there, tried to pull it, I tried my pry bar. Sometimes that works, right? You pull it a little bit, goes right back on track when you move it around again. But this time it didn't. So I got my tools. I got a 17 millimeter and a 19 millimeter. I'm gonna move this around a little bit so I can get more room to work. See if it moves a little bit. And yeah, we'll fix this right up. Don't be afraid of this, guys. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go right there, take that cap off, loosen up the grease fitting for that, right there for that idler, and it should be able to pull it out. like to keep the screws right where they belong so I don't lose them in this dirt. Luckily, it's not too bad. Nice and clean. As I dirty it up. All right. All right. As soon as you loosen it, it starts moving. It's cracking there. You hear it cracking, slowly moving. Let's help it out. Gotta loosen it up a little more. Just took the grease fitting off. Now to keep on prying it off. Alrighty, so welcome to day two. So obviously after I took off all of the fluid or grease from the track, I realized it wasn't gonna be as simple as just getting the track back on, because the actual problem is right down there. So as you can see right there, so this root ball attacked back and got this skid steer stuck. So I spent, I think, 3 or 4 hours yesterday basically lifting the skid steer up using that and putting rocks under it so that I can get more and more of it as high as possible away from that. And then eventually I want to put enough rocks or wood back there so that when I lift here, the whole thing gets up in the air. And once it's up in the air, I'm able to then use my rope and pull it using my wife's X5. It's a deleted and tuned diesel X5. Love that thing. So let's go ahead and see what I can do here. All right, so what I did was I put that piece of wood right there under the back, and I lifted the front, and it freed up the track just enough. I think that's all I need to do. And if I just move the track back and forth, I should be able to get it on. Let's hope I can. Let's see what I can do. So it didn't quite do it for me. So we can see it's on the power sprocket. That's the idler pulley. So it's on that properly, finally. I used this rope down here to get her done. And yeah, so that's the final one right there. I'm gonna see if I can pry it on there with a pry bar or something. So you'll have to forgive me, I've been working on this for 2 days and I just wanted it to be done and didn't know this was going to work, but it worked beautifully. What I had to do, like I showed you, was lift it up higher to free this whole thing up. As you can see, it's nice and free. And there's the blocks of wood back there. You guys can see right there, the blocks of wood are right there. Lifting up this whole thing in the air. And then I tied it up to the X5. Still under tension. After I tied it up, went inside, moved the tracks around left and right, and it popped right on. You felt it go pop. So a little bit more difficult if you're a one-man show like me. My wife did come out and help a little bit, thank God for her. If it wasn't for her, I'd probably be dead under it or something, who knows. But we did it. It's free. Now let's go ahead and refill the track and get it all tensioned up. All right, so the only thing that's left is to tighten up the nipple and use my little Milwaukee grease gun to tighten it up. So let's go ahead and tighten everything up, finish up here. All right, time for it to come out of its hole. It's been long enough. Let's see if we can do it.